Well, we are joined in studio now by Robert Vessman, known to his friends as Bear.
Absolutely. It's been my nickname for quite some time.
Really?
Yeah, I give great bear hugs. That's what I don't think about.
That's so nice. We'll get one after the interview. Now, we are going to be talking about The Farm, which started originally as a rehearsal studio. But you're launching an opportunity for musicians to get out of their basements, join a band, and experience life as a professional musician for a few weeks. And the program is called The Farm Rock. So tell us a bit about the inspiration behind this.
Well, the inspiration was, since I run the rehearsal studios, it was kind of a common lead-in. I had so many guys who came into the rehearsal space, men and women, let's be clear on that, who sort of said, hey, it'd be kind of neat to play with other people.
Right.
There were bands that come in and rehearse, and they were already full bands, but then people came in and they were individuals who came in to practice their drums or guitar or do some vocals and things like that, but always said, hey, it'd be really cool to play with other people. Mm-hmm. We're not reinventing the wheel here, but we're going to have some fun doing this. It's a 12-week program, and we put people into bands, put them on stages, get them into a recording studio, and then have them play for their family and friends at the end for a big-ass show.
That sounds great. And is there an age range? We're talking like, you know.
Well, we're kind of gearing at calling it an adult music league.
Okay.
Because I think that's where we, you know, I think a lot of adults, as you know yourself, life happens, right?
Yep.
And you grow up and all of a sudden you're saying, well, I used to do this, but maybe I'd like to do it again now because I have the time. Mm-hmm. So, you know, 19 and over is kind of where we're looking at.
Christine, this is your big chance. You could sing.
Yeah, right. I'm just wondering. I'm sort of wondering at the I now see the context that it would be something that you had done in your youth and then life happens and you'd like to get back to it, but you've now lost your connections, right? Whereas younger people, would there be a market for that too, do you
Absolutely,
think?
Absolutely, I think. I mean, the School of Rock exists and they gear towards their things towards the younger adults. Long & McQuaid has been doing, you know, youth programs for as long as I've known Long & McQuaid to exist. So those things have been around a long time. But as you said, the adults sometimes who did this when they were younger, all of a sudden, you know, kids happened, jobs happened,
life got
travel
in the way.
Happens. All those things happened, and you still want to play your guitar, or you want to sing, or you play the drums, but you do it with your records downstairs or in the garage. But it would be really nice to have someone else who has the same mindset, or other people who have the same mindset.
So, tell us about the program. How long is it? What happens if you have nothing but vocalists who show up and you've got no band? You've got nothing but band and no instrument players and no vocalists. Like, how logistically this must be?
It does present challenges, but you know, you got a room full of vocalists. There's all sorts of a cappella groups that exist, right?
Oh, yeah. Right.
So why not?
That.
You know,
right.
We have people who work in the industry. Mm-hmm. We're going to call those guys sidemen. Because that's what they do. They help the other band members out.
Session musicians.
We have these guys. Friends of mine, I don't know if you recall a band back in the day, Mad About Plaid.
Oh, my goodness.
The bass player from that band. Yeah, there you go. The bass player from that band has been my friend since we were kids.
Oh, that's awesome.
And he's been, he just finished a tour with the Drifters, and he's been a sideman for all sorts of things and a producer. So he's one of our instructors that's coming in to help out. So if we have a room full of singers, let's see what happens. Mm-hmm. Why not?
You're ready to go with the flow.
Right. Sure.
So what do they do? They just sign up?
It's a 12-week program. Mm-hmm. So they sign up for 12 weeks. It happens every Wednesday at the Farm Rehearsal Studios in Markham.
Which is where in Markham?
In Markham, Major Mac and McCowan.
Right.
So we have all the rooms there. So the infrastructure is already existing. Mm-hmm. So we put them into bands. Hopefully we can get a drummer, a bass player, a guitar player, a singer, or a keyboard player.
Is this all day or?
No, it goes from 7 o'clock to 10 o'clock at night.
Okay.
Once a week. And, you know, they get together, they pick their songs that they want to learn. And then the sidemen or, you know, the hired guns come in to help them out through the process and they help them learn the songs. If they want to learn an original song, go for it.
So is there going to be any sort of form of audition? Do people need to be at a certain level or are you just figuring that people that really can't play and can't sing aren't going to show up?
You know, I think we should open the door to everyone who has a desire to play some music and has that. I think it makes sense to do that. I don't think it should be restricted, but obviously, it's better if you have some kind of talent. You know how to play an instrument. It does make things easier getting to the next level. Because imagine yourself trying to learn a whole new song when you only know one chord, right?
Right. Yeah.
It does present a problem. But, you know, we don't have auditions. We actually fill out a registration form.
Okay.
And it, you know, asks their favorite band, their favorite singer, what kind of music they like, and other music references that they like, and ask if they either play another instrument or things like that. And then we sort of gauge it from there.
And you're also taking them around other studios so they can see what it's like? It's not just the performance?
Well, the rehearsals will happen at the farm rehearsal studios.
Right.
But then about 4 weeks or 5 weeks into the program, we get them into a live venue and they play their first live tour concert.
Oh, after 4 weeks.
Four or 5 weeks. We sort of get them get them in.
We take the whole 12, Christine. Let's make this.
Well, you know, some takes a little longer.
I would need 12.
I play
weeks
the triangle pretty well.
We can use a triangle. You never know. I'm a percussionist, so triangles work.
Okay. So how does that work? Would they all be in the same room, or do you have enough studios?
Well, right, we have four separate studios at the farm. So so we're going to four different bands. So after the 6th week, we put them on stage. So they actually play for their peers the first time out, and they do get critiqued, but critiqued in a way that, you know, it's encouraging for them to continue and want them to do.
You're not going to be Simon Cowell on them.
Oh, heck no.
Okay, good.
No. There's no intent of trying to discourage people from doing this. The whole idea is to get more people interested in music and grow the community. You know, that's the whole intent of the idea. So they play for their family and basically for their friends for this first show. Then they're back in the rehearsal studio for a couple of weeks, then back out to another live show that they do again and learn more from the coaches and things like that. Then we put them into a recording studio to record a song. Then they're back on and to do rehearsal and then back for one more final show, which is a big showcase where they get to play for their family and friends and their colleagues.
That sounds awesome. Wow. Okay, so how much does this cost?
Oh, hundreds and thousands of dollars. $79 a week.
Oh, my. That's amazing.
For 12 weeks. So it works out to about...
just over $800.
About $1,000with that. You know, that HST stuff has to kick in.
Yeah. So that's a pretty good deal for the experience. Again, and how do people register? I know your website is thefarmrocks.net.
Yes.
It's being revamped a bit.
It is.
But people still get there. So they can email you at info@thefarmrocks.net.
Yes.
And that you have a Facebook page as well.
Yes.
Which is Farm Rehearsal Studios with the S on the end. They can register by going to the website or just emailing you at info@thefarmrocks.net.
That way, if they have any more questions they need answered or that, I can definitely help them out.
When is the first program starting?
First session is kicking off June 6th.
Oh.
So we're about under 3 weeks away for our inaugural kickoff.
But but it's ongoing. It's not going to be just if people can't, you know, they don't have the time to sign up for the first one,
hoping to run three tours a year. So the next one starts October 3rd.
And what do you do if a star band is born?
We will try to nurture that. Why not? You know, it's inevitable that people are going to enjoy each other's company if it works. And sometimes, if you guys know anything about the music industry, sometimes bands work and sometimes they don't. If you look at the Gallagher brothers, they worked for a certain period of time. Now they're done.
So did Fleetwood Mac, apparently.
Apparently. But if a band happens to come out of this situation, we will definitely try to nurture them and help them on. I have other friends of mine in the industry who are booking agents, who are talent agents, who, you know, wrangle crowds for MTV and CTV and stuff like that. So we can definitely put them in the right direction and help them out with that.
Well, if you know someone out there, this would be a great thing.
Yeah,
this would be a great present, wouldn't it?
Great present, a fabulous present, yeah. So do you expect anybody to like maybe go through the program and quit their day job?
You know, if it's something you really want to do, go for it. But I suggest you keep your day job and enjoy this whole process. This is really more of a, you know, I need something else to do and relax. And a hobby. Exactly.
A passion.
Exactly. It's more, that's what it's really geared for.
But I think it's nice because you're also getting the benefit of, as well as the experience for you to, you know, see studios and go in, you're also getting the benefit of the professionals that you'll be working with.
Oh, absolutely.
So
absolutely. They're willing to give back. Yeah.
And spending time with people who also have a passion and are sort of coming from the same place. And
absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And I'm hoping that the ladies out there who are listening to this are, you know, let your spouses know about this too. It's okay if they want to join. But, you know, I think there's a lot of women out there who are very, very talented and would like maybe this opportunity to do something like this.
Of course there are. Because once again, the website is thefarmrocks.net. And you can get some information there or at Farm Rehearsal Studios on Facebook. Well, Bear, good luck with this. It's a great initiative.
Thank you very much. And thanks for having me. I certainly appreciate it. She's magical, mystical.